Where is this kind of more dynamic, complex notion of identity found in a city? My notion about this is that you're more likely to find that in the liminal spaces between communities, tasks, geographies of the city, than you are in neatly defined centers. In other words, that this kind of complex identity is tied to the notion of an edge. And the principle of a living edge of this sort is twofold. It's both porous and resistant. And I think the challenge for designers, urban designers, and perhaps even for architects, is how to create that liminal space and thereby to get people who differ, whether it's by economic class or racially or in terms of the way they live their lives, to give them more experience of interaction. That is, to thicken their identities.
And this is the Chinese garage, not in Croydon, but quite close to it in Bromley, which is a petrol filling station, now a car showroom in a Chinese stroke mock Tudor style, which it's not really meant to be a joke, really what is truly authentic. We've been talking a little bit about authenticity.
Who do you think you are? I've spent 20 years with organisations fretting over that, and they can kind of be liberated now. They can stop worrying so much about presenting these immaculately controlled, you know, totally consistent corporate panaceas, boundaries actually, because it's not tenable. And actually your brand is who we think you are. It's like beauty in the eye of the beholder. The corporate brand is really who we think you are. And unfortunately that changes by the minute.
I wanted to make something. This is the something. That's the best word for it that I can come up with. This is the something. I wanted to hand the something over to 9 other artists. And I wanted them to look at that and use it as a shard, as a trigger. Not to translate it, but to use it. And to some extent, it was about breaking down or using different arts as a boundary that we could walk across into each other's territory. We could peel back our understanding and walk into somebody else's territory and see what we found there.
As part of Open House Weekend, I started to run these walking tours of Central Croydon via its 7 hills, via the 7 car parks. There's something about the repetition, the fact that it happens every year, that it's me that does it, that it's always a group of strangers that turn up for some reason to join me on this tour, usually from Croydon, but often from lots of different places around the world, which is constantly surprising to me.
It's very difficult to get to complete authenticity, but relative authenticity is hugely important. If I have to choose between Skansen Open Air Museum and Disneyland, I choose Skansen every time.
For me, what I've been hearing is this a very ephemeral discussion, or a discussion about ephemeral identities, which has no sense of deep, real and authentic identity, which is what I think we should be looking for in be it built environment or be it in society, be it in culture, which I think is one of the great ills of our current age.
The whole point is I'm everything inside me outside, and I think that's what we're got to look at the buildings, what we're designing for the future, is that you're not just designing for the community they're living in, it's the community that they're interacting with on this sort of social network world.
It may be that our clarity is better because we're going down the rootage of things rather than just accepting the first name that comes or the first brand that is there. And does that make our life more interesting and does it make it more possible? So the clarity is not instant, but eventually you get there because you've gone down tributaries of knowledge.
So these are multiple and confusing issues, and at the time of austerity, I have a sort of a optimistic belief that maybe we will do away with kind of surplus fakery, and maybe we will realize that the authentic is also maybe cheaper.